Hey, hi, hello everybody, and welcome to another episode of the XCOM 2 News. Today we have a new trailer to look at, the inside look on the Reaper class that is going to come with the new expansion. And you guys wanted me to do it without previous watching of the video, just, you know, fresh off the base, then that is how I'm going to do it. And that means I have no idea what it is that is ahead of me, and I'm waiting like a couple of hours already to see that fucking trailer. But I can't because my kids didn't go to sleep before now, so it's a bit late, but I think we can do this, right? So I'm just peering to the back because that's where I have the second monitor to see if everything is fine. So let's go and check out the stuff scene by scene and see what we can extrapolate, shall we? So, again, somebody's gonna
Commander,
be smoking.
Commander, I have new information on a faction calling themselves the Reapers. They're a fiercely independent group and stick to the wilds outside Advent control.
So they would probably be, well, obviously hanging around in the abandoned cities that we see here. And we have codes. So finally we have codes. That we've been, you know, the game was calling for codes since it launched. And they seem to be more like an urban area outside of Advent control rather than wilderness. That's about it for now, right?
Their field agents specialize in stealth without sacrificing power.
So, just like we all do, don't we?
If you can unite our teams, they will be invaluable in our fight against the Chosen.
Miss some Stalker. It looks like Stalker, doesn't it?
Reapers use a new form of stealth they call Shadow Concealment.
Wait, go back. What? Reapers use an advanced form of concealment called Shadow, which only has a chance to break after taking actions. Consecutive actions increase the chance of being revealed, while in Shadow Reapers have increased mobility and enemies have smaller detection radii. Okay, so that's basically like, I don't know if you have been seeing the Suppressor mod in the workshop and the longer version of it that adds, well, the exact same mechanic but without the bonuses. So I see again that we have a mod being put into the main game right now. So I suppose it's going to work like just like that mod, that we are going to be taking action, we then have a roll against ever increasing detection chance until we finally get caught. And there probably are going to be some skills reducing that. I see some probably perk icons here. And it's gonna be like a bar feeling. That's a good thing to know. We don't have a point value, instead we have bars. What do we have? Locate Advent Field Commander, add kill Field Commander, neutralize all enemy targets. So it seems like this is a look into a new mission type, it seems. And also a new rifle is going to have 3 ammo. And yeah, here we can see this is the perk, because it's on the task bar and it's on also over here.
Our soldiers give away their position after firing a single round, but Shadow Concealment can keep a Reaper hidden even after initiating an attack. Despite...
See, the bar is filling over here, we have the chance to reveal and... yeah, that's working just like the Long War 2 and the Vanilla Suppressor mod.
Their focus on stealth, Reapers can still make a lot of noise using their powerful vector rifles and explosive claymores.
Claymores are mines, aren't they?
Once a Reaper has set a claymore, any soldier can detonate it at any time.
So that's something like proximity mine plus. You can toss it and start a fight with it. That seems to work exactly like we were using the proximity mines in the XCOM 1 until in Long War the pods have been activated by placing prox mines on them. But yeah, it seems like we can now completely do this, and they will disregard the huge giant ass claymore sitting there. And I wonder one thing that is very important. If you put a claymore on the ground and then toss a grenade on it, are you going to also activate it? Because that means much more explodey explosions, doesn't it?
These can be used to turn Advent into walking bombs. Using the homing mine ability, attach a claymore to an enemy, and the next time they take damage, will be to your advantage.
So that's like the Psy... Oh, hello, tree, skill tree. So that's like a Psy ability to explode somebody's grenade, but probably better. And hey, I wonder if we could combine it. You can attach a claymore to somebody, to a mutant for example, and then have a psionic guy explode the mutant's grenade, also exploding the claymore. I'm just thinking about possible combos right now, because that's probably what I'm going to be doing for like a first month or two after the expansion comes out. Just make the biggest possible booms, because that's me. So what do we have? We have two skills on squaddy, then corporal, sergeant. So it seems like we are going to have a rather different looking skill tree, doesn't it? Or what's up? Because we have saboteur, stealth skill trees. The saboteur will probably have a lot to do with the claymore, I believe. And the XCOM skills, this is this vital point targeting. The cone of that kill zone, and what that might be. Holo targeting? I can't remember. So we have the new stealth mechanic. That's probably something either improving aim or crit during stealth. Makes stealth last longer, maybe?
Reapers can
maximize
their stealth capabilities by choosing skills that get them back into shadow mode faster and keep them hidden for longer.
I guess that's that then, that they just explained to me what the perks do and I don't have to worry now about it anymore. I'm going to. So, let's go back. This is actually pretty interesting. But there isn't really much to extrapolate. This probably means we are, shooting out the whole magazine out at the enemy. This is probably return to stealth on a kill if you get revealed or something. Yeah, this tree is definitely about claymores, because you can see the radius of radii of explosions and stuff like that. And yeah, that's probably about as much as we can extrapolate from here, right? So this probably fills our stealth bar on kills. This probably allows us to return to stealth once we are already uncovered. This maybe increases damage while attacking from stealth. This I don't know, winning free beer and at Dart Championship probably. And yeah, so yeah, those are the perks that I don't really know what they do. Probably something around accuracy. And yeah, I think we have the rest covered.
By choosing skills that get them back into shadow mode faster and keep them hidden for longer. Or they may decide to go on the offensive. With remote start, Reapers can set off any explosive in their sightline, causing extra damage within a wider radius.
So that's the exact same ability as the Spec Ops class for Long War 2 has. That's a mod also, of course. Yeah, I have a feeling we are going to see a lot of mods repurposed to fit into the campaign, into vanilla campaign. That's good and bad. It's good because, you know, we won't have to use so many mods, and bad because, it's kinda seems like leeching original concepts from the mods, right? On the other hand, there is so many mods that it's going to be hard to come up with something completely new, so I'm not going to hold that against the devs, but I'm watching you.
We need to seek out the Reaper faction and get them on our side.
Wait, what? Was that Bert Gamer? It does seem like Bert Gamer, but with beard and not bald. At least the wall is exactly the same as Bert's bunker. And that's a berserker, but this probably is a graboid.
And get them on our side. Their enhanced stealth and heavy hitting attacks mean they can provide support from the shadows on one turn, and a full-on assault on the next.
Wait, that shot broke the roof of the car and dropped everybody down, okay.
Good luck, Commander.
Yeah, good luck. Oh, so it exploded the whole car. So that's like a shot that causes giant explosion of things that can explode. Fine. I've seen that before. So, that's actually pretty interesting. I would say that while the Reaper may not exactly be something that we haven't seen before, if we consider the mod scene, that's definitely a very interesting look. And the skill tree is definitely fun, although, you know, I'm going to eat my hat if my guesses towards the perks were wrong. I can say that freely because I don't own a hat. So I'm curious, what are the two perks that I couldn't figure out based on the the icon? And it seems like it's going to be a mix between the Spec Ops class and the suppressor mod. So that's interesting, when we are only going to have a couple of them per mission because they're hero units, and they will have some play and counter play, balancing the kills versus overriding the enemy suspicion. Let's see, let's go back. Pop, there we go, there we have it. So yeah, I suppose that this 50% is the action allowance that we are going to be having for the special stealth, and the chance to reveal will be rising with every action or something like that. This is an interesting thing to look at. And here you can see XCOM gained one ability point from an ambush kill. So we see at least one requisition to get an ability point for the new skill tree for the hero troops and the normal troops also. And they're going to be having a nice little graphic around, so you don't miss them. I wonder if you're going to see like a list of those special events, because it's something that we all want to keep track of, right? And we heard that the rifle is going to have many modifications, but what I see here is that this may not exactly be the case. They don't really show us the mod window, but we've seen it with scope at some point. See, there is only one available slot for upgrade, and that is curious. Did they mean that it is going to be very modifiable because we can upgrade the same rifle throughout technology levels, so through from ballistic to mag to plasma, while keeping it as the same rifle, rather than changing the whole weapon? And calling a chick using sniper rifle Dragunova is not the irony lost on me. I'm watching you. So yeah, I think that's about it. I think that's about everything I can tell from just watching the trailer once. You can see that we have nice little graphics around here. And we have also, just now, gain knowledge that these are not skills on cooldown. We have limited use of most of them. So I see the claymore here has zero uses because it's already been blown. That's probably another ability. Maybe exploding all the bombs in the radius. That's interesting. So yeah, that's about everything I can tell you from just looking at the trailer once. I'm going to bid you farewell, but before I go, I will urge you that you may like the video, subscribe to the channel if you wanna, and I am giving you my great thanks to the Patreon supporters. And if you want to, you can check out other content on my channel. We have Let's Plays testing stuff out on the stream live, and soon there are going to be build videos, so feel free to look around if you're new to the channel. So, with that being said, see you guys later, and bye-bye.